I am a mother of three. I got a 10-year-old boy and two girls, 7 and 6. And pretty much my life revolves around my kids. I was in a motel, and to stay in the motels, you have to have the money before like 11 a.m. or noon, depending on the person. If when you're trying to get the jobs, they want certain hours for you to work and stuff like that. And when you got kids to and from school and you have to pay a motel every day, $100 or more every single day, you kind of like have to try to get something that would work around those hours. Well, it didn't really work out that way. I'd take my kids to school, they get dropped off around 7:50, 8 o'clock. Then I'd get on the bus, go down to Gateway or Mall 205, and I'd take the receipts to the hotel, and I would go around and I'd say, hey, look, I need people to help us. I have to pay this money by this time, and if I can't pay this, I'm gonna get kicked out with my kids. So people would come down and they would help pay the room. Some people wouldn't do anything. Pretty much you might ask 100 people, but only one person says yes. And then when 11 a.m. would come around, usually the room would be paid for. As soon as I'd be done paying the room, go sit down for a little bit, collect my thoughts, go pick up my kids, and then start the whole, you know, make dinner, clean, take care of the kids, and then wake up the next day and do the same thing all over again. Actually, I'd met a lady when I was out asking people for help, and I've seen her more than once. She ended up approaching me and telling me, hey, there's this person that you should talk to. A really nice, helpful person. I told him what my story was, and he got me connected with Northwest Housing Alternatives in Milwaukee. Just awesome people. I don't even know how to explain it enough. They'll help you, and they'll listen. Even if they can't do anything, they'll try, you know, or get connections to somebody that might know. And so pretty much they helped me. As for the housing, my kids are like really resilient. Honestly, when we were in motels, they just thought it was a brand new house. They just thought it was like, oh, we're going to a new place, yay, you know. But when they got in here, they really loved that they had got to have their own, like, own rooms, and they got to, you know, be able to have their own space, like, and that they don't have to worry about like a housekeeper knocking on the door every day. But they've been actually stronger than I have, to be honest. School-wise, they're awesome. They just kind of do their schoolwork, and all my kids pretty much got A's. Like, I've been trying to go to school for a while. When I got this place, I was like, the first thing I'm gonna do is sign up for school. So I signed up for school at PCC. I like it a lot. It's actually really, really good school, to be honest. They're pretty hands-on. If I can get people just wanting to help or anything like that, there's gotta be a job out there that would pertain to that, that I know that I can do, and I know that I'll do well. My all-term around goal is pretty much, when I get through this, get a job, make sure that by the time my kids are my age, you know, if I pass away or God forbid or something happened, that they'll have something to fall back on, and it'll be, you know, whatever I have. And I'm also, you know, showing my kids that, you know, like, even when there's stuff that's really hard, you know, you can do it. It just, keep trying. There's always a way up, because once you're at the bottom, there's nowhere else to go besides up. So pretty much that.